Dosto, the title for today is the famous old comic novel Don Quixote. Well, there are two ways to pronounce it: Don Quixote or Don Quixote, the ingenious gentleman, Sir Quixote of La Mancha, or just Don Quixote is a Spanish novel by Miguel de Cervantes. So the pronunciations are very different because it's Spanish. The book was published in two parts in 1605 and 1615, that is 1615. Don Quixote is the most influential work of literature from the Spanish Golden Age and the entire Spanish literature, or rather Spanish literary canon, as a founding work of modern Western literature. It regularly appears high on lists of the great works of fiction ever published, such as Book Club and World Library Collection, that cites Don Quixote as the author's choice for the best literary work ever written. The story follows the adventures of a noble Hidalgo, which means a gentleman in Spanish, named Alonso Quixano, who reads so many of these chivalric romances that he loses his sanity and decides to become a knight errant, a medieval knight relating to Middle Ages, wandering in search of chivalrous adventures. So the theme of the book is very far-fetched. So what I was saying was, this particular gentleman wandering in search of chivalrous adventures, reviving chivalry and serving his country under the name of Don Quixote de la Mancha. He recruits a simple farmer by the name of Sancho Panza as his squire, or you could say attendant or an aide, who often employs a unique earthy or crude wit in dealing with Don Quixote's rhetorical orations on antiquated knighthood. Don Quixote in the first part of the book does not see the world for what it is and prefers to imagine that he is living out a knightly or a chivalrous story. The work opens in the village of La Mancha, Spain, where a country gentleman's infatuation with books of chivalry leads him to decide to become a knight errant, and he assumes the name of Don Quixote. He finds an antique suit of armor and attaches a visor made of pasteboard to an old helmet. He then declares that this old irritant is the noble horse Rocinante. According to Don Quixote, a knight errant also needs a lady to love, and so he selects a peasant girl from a nearby town, christening her Dulcinea del Toboso. Dulcinea del Toboso. Thereafter, he dresses up and heads out to perform deeds of heroism in her name. He arrives at an inn which he believes is a castle and insists that the innkeeper knight him, or you could say honor him. After being told that he must carry money and extra clothes, Don Quixote decides to go home, but on his way he picks up a fight with a group of merchants and they beat him up. When he recovers, he persuades the peasant Sancho Panza to act as his squire, with the promise that Sancho will one day get an island to rule. Don Quixote and Sancho, mounted on a donkey, set out in their first adventure. which is, when you read the book, it's very interesting. So they set out on their first adventure. Don Quixote mistakes a field of windmills for giants and attempts to fight them, but finally concludes that a magician must have turned the giants into windmills. So these were thoughts of those times. He later attacks a group of monks, thinking that they have imprisoned a princess, and also battles with a herd of sheep, among other adventures, almost all of which end with Don Quixote, Sancho, or both being beaten up. Eventually, Don Quixote acquires a metal wash basin from a barber. Now, this too is also very funny. He acquires a metal wash basin from a barber, which he believes is a helmet once worn by a famous knight, and he later frees a group of convicted criminals. Don Quixote subsequently encounters Cardenio, who lives like a wild man in the woods because he believes that Lucinda, the woman he loves, betrayed him. Don Quixote decides to emulate him to prove his great love for Dulcinea, and he sends Sancho to deliver a letter to her. When Sancho stops at an inn, he finds two of Don Quixote's old friends, a priest and a barber, are looking for him. They decide that one of them should pose as a young girl in distress to try and lure Don Quixote home. En route, they come across a young woman, Dorothy, who has who was betrayed by one Don Fernando, who married Lucinda. Dorothy agrees to pretend to be a princess whose kingdom has been seized by a giant, and Don Quixote is persuaded to help her. They stop at the inn where Don Fernando and Lucinda soon arrive. Where Lucinda is reunited with Cardenio, and Don Fernando promises to marry Dorothy. Later, the priest and the barber put Don Quixote in a wooden cage and persuade him that he is under a particular enchantment that will take him to Dulcinea. Eventually, they return home, and finally, all these couples are hooked. Part 2 begins a month after the end of the part 1, but many of the characters have already read that book and so know about Don Quixote. He is convinced that Dulcinea is under an enchantment that has turned her into an ordinary peasant girl. Don Quixote and Sancho meet a duke and duchess who are prone to pranks. In one such trick, they persuade the two men that Sancho must give himself 3,300 lashes to break the curse on Dulcinea. The Duke later makes Sancho the governor of a town that he tells Sancho is the Isle of Barataria. Now, Barataria is somewhere around, in today's world, it is Trinidad, somewhere near there. That place. There, Sancho is presented with various disputes, and he shows wisdom in his decisions. However, after a week in office and being subjected to other pranks, he decides to give up the governorship. In the meantime, the Duke and the Duchess play other tricks on Don Quixote. Eventually, Don Quixote and Sancho leave after learning that a false sequel to the book about him says that he traveled to Zaragoza, a place in Spain. Don Quixote decides to avoid that city and go instead to Barcelona, following various adventures there. Don Quixote is challenged by the Knight of the White Moon there, who happens to be a student from La Mancha in disguise, and he is defeated. According to the terms of the battle, Don Quixote is now required to return home. Along the way, Sancho pretends to administer the required lashings to himself, and they meet a character from the false sequel. After they arrive home, Don Quixote falls ill, renounces all the chivalry as a foolish fiction, and dies. Cervantes, a strikingly modern narrative, gives a voice to a dazzling assortment of characters with very diverse beliefs and perspectives, and it exhibits a nuanced irony, a humanistic outlook, and a pronounced comic edge. I would like to add to this that the book also gives you at times a feel as if you are reading some kind of a fairy tale. The popularity of the first volume led to the publication in 1614 of a spurious sequel by someone calling himself Alonso Fernandez, a circumstance that Cervantes addressed in his own second volume. So friends, overall it's a very lengthy read. It's around 750 pages. Considering the times we are living in, when the attention span has really shortened and diversions have mushroomed around books, one can say it's extremely, extremely lengthy. I would give the book 8 out of 10. And yes, if you have the time, do immerse yourself in it. Goodbye and see you soon.